and let's drive right into action with the fourth amateur fight of our evening. Seymour versus Shorjia.
Fight number four, lightweight division. Luca, what can we expect from these two warriors?
Well, we've just started off with a fantastic connection from a right hand from Seymour, actually. At the moment, we see Seymour being the younger fighter, however, having a larger experience of fights. But this is definitely a fantastic, experienced amateur matchup.
Absolutely. A great, great left hook there.
Absolutely. At the moment, we see Seymour doing a very good job with the striking, making connections, not getting hit.
Daniel, the home fighter representing Spinning Eto'o Brothers fist. Championship Gym.
I tell you what, Seymour was looking very confident on his way in. Good body shot from Seymour. Shorjia trying to figure out his range and work his way back into this fight.
I would say both fighters are looking very confident right now.
Absolutely, absolutely. Seymour with a very good jab, good footwork, another good body shot. Ooh. Okay, there we go. Now Seymour going for the takedown. Let's see Shorjia's defense. Shorjia using the cage. Very good job from Shorjia. Now Shorjia has to try and turn back into Seymour. Yes, and work his way for the underhooks, doing a great job. Fantastic. You can hear the crowd, Shorjia being the local fighter, you can hear the crowd screaming his name. Very good, he broke. He did a very good job in defending that takedown.
Absolutely, and actually that just goes to show how revered MMA is in Central Europe, in Austria, because, you know, the crowd themselves actually really follow the fight step by step and really understanding exactly what's going on, which, you know, it's great to see in the MMA scene.
Absolutely. Okay, very, very good. Shorjia is looking a little bit sharper now. He entered the round, he got hit a couple of times. He needed a little bit of time to, you know, find his range, but now he's looking a little bit more comfortable, I think, after that takedown defense. Mm.
30 seconds left of the round.
Seymour now also a little bit more careful. Good return from Shorjia. Big deep breath from Seymour, and again, great counter strike. Shorjia now building in confidence.
I think the third time that Marcel has actually walked straight into a jab or a hook from Daniel.
Absolutely, and that's why he's probably gone for this takedown attempt to try and secure this round in some way. However, Shorjia has shown a very, very good takedown defense, now turns me onto the cage, and that's round one, ladies and gentlemen. Buddy, what are your thoughts on this round?
Oh, I give that completely to Daniel on this round. I think he was, you know, although they both stood and they were both really confident, I think he was a more dominant fighter. I also believe that he connected with the more scoring shots, and he rocked. I think there's a couple of times that he rocked Marcel, but Marcel still looks fresh. He still looks ready. He's not injured. I'm excited for round number two. What are
absolutely.
Your thoughts?
Me too, absolutely. Yeah, at the beginning of the round, I thought Marcel entered with a little bit more aggression and worked a little bit better. But after the first minute, as soon as Daniel was able to secure that takedown defense and fight back, then I think he won the round there. He did much more work and finished the round.
I agree with you on that one. I agree with you. And also, I think it's, you know, Daniel should go into round number two being very confident in his striking ability and the fact that he is actually, you know, the more dominant fighter as a striker against Marcel.
Absolutely. Now, round number two. Seymour definitely still looking full of energy. He just jumped a couple of times in his corner before the fight. Fantastic to see.
And once again, Daniel looking to dominate this fight.
Yeah, absolutely. Daniel has really broken into his rhythm. You can see it now. You can see, oh, very, very good 1-2 from Seymour. Very good. Daniel throwing right back, trying to push him towards the back of the cage. Good, good body shot. Yeah, you can tell these guys are two experienced amateurs. This is very good level, very technical striking.
Absolutely. I would even hazard a guess to say that Marcel Seymour is actually athlete, an experienced boxer. His stance, you know, and his in his movement, very much like a proficient boxer.
Absolutely, he's bobbing and weaving.
Yeah,
he's doing a great job.
True, but Daniel is still able to connect, still able to catch him.
Absolutely. Absolutely. He's pushing it. He's keeping it simple, you know. One, yeah. Two, out. One, two, out. He's doing a great job.
Absolutely. Listen to his corner, taking the advice, really sticking to his game plan, dominating this second round, too.
To be honest, it's still close in the striking level. Sometimes Marcel comes out with some dangerous bombs. I mean, he's throwing these overhands that could make loads of damage if he connects.
All right, that's it, right? It's great throwing those that look flashy, that look great, but if you don't connect, it's not a scoring punch.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And that's also pretty exhausting for him as well.
Okay, he's got the back. Now he's got a good chance for a takedown, and he's got the takedown.
Great takedown.
Fantastic work. Now he's going to see if he can get some hooks in and work for the back. Shorjia now, great work from Shorjia. Right back up to his feet, getting the underhooks. We've seen him do this before. Turns into the cage, and now he's going to try and probably either disengage or go for the takedown himself.
Great confidence from Daniel there. Didn't get phased, didn't get rattled by the fact that he got taken down and his back was, he almost got dominated under the bat. Poised, composed,
absolutely.
Back on his feet, dominant position yet again.
Absolutely. Fantastic work.
100%.
Good work from Marcel trying to change levels for Shorjia. Oh, expected that. Wow, big scramble between the guys. Back to standing. Nebil Sabai making sure both fighters are safe. Last 20 seconds of our second round of the evening.
Match number four.
Last 10 seconds. Daniel Shorjia trying to look for the counter strike, heading back. Marcel
connected with that one too.
Did a very good job. Yeah. Absolutely, absolutely.
And that was round number two. Luca, for me again, this is a contrasting fight to the previous one, where it's, you know, where the striking game here, I think this is at another level. Every single fight just seems to elevate cage fight series more and more.
Absolutely. And what we see as well is that the fighters are actually going from grappling in the previous fight to a great striking bout in the fight before, and now mixing it up. Actually, you see, when they get a little bit more experienced, you know, they start to use a little bit of both their skills, mixing them up. They go from striking to grappling to takedowns, back up. It's fantastic.
Yeah. So right now, I would say for me, two rounds dominated by Daniel, right?
Absolutely.
But Marcel could still come back and take this one. He just has to.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think the second round was pretty close, to be honest. Ladies and gentlemen, the final round of the fourth amateur bout of our evening, Seymour versus Shorjia. Great work from Seymour. And Seymour looking for the takedown, doing a fantastic job. Very good. You can hear Marcel's corner making sure they communicate to him everything he needs to hear. It's fantastic for a fighter to know that his corner is there for him in the last round when he's struggling to have that extra strength behind him.
Yeah, but still a dominant performance of Daniel. Daniel is not giving up, and his strikes are doing some real damage. But he's getting caught, though. His stand-up defense, I mean, his striking defense is not you know, his hands are too low. He needs to protect his face because, you know, Marcel could still win this if he gets a knockout.
Absolutely, absolutely. And to be honest, in the striking, even though Shoji has the advantage, I do still see it's been a pretty close fight, you know, because Marcel is hitting back.
He is hitting back, you know, so those strikes need to connect, and all he has to do is just get that one clean shot that's going to take Marcel, that's going to take Daniel out. But Daniel is still very much...
Very, very good connection. Daniel shakes it off.
I would say, in my opinion, Daniel is still very much in favor of winning this, but he's got to be careful. We still have just over a minute left to go, and Marcel is looking very comfortable right now.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, Marcel is going to have to try and really make an effort in this last minute of the last round. Nebil Sabai always making sure the fight is fair according to the amateur rules to make sure our fighters are safe.
Yeah, and so there, you know, it looked like it was an elbow, which obviously you can't do in an amateur bout. So great call from the referee.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. I believe he was trying. Daniel Shoji asking for a standing man.
Yeah.
He gets the knockdown. He wants to finish, but Marcel back to life, standing right back up. Fantastic to see.
Great tenacity from both fighters.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Final 15 seconds.
Wow, I've got goosebumps. Now, it looks like Daniel really wants to get that finish. He's going to strike. He's tired, but he's pushing. He's risking as well.
Yeah, he's got to be careful here.
He's got the fight in him, though, eh? He really wants it. Fantastic. Nothing better to finish a fight like this and nobody going to the ground. Fabulous to see.
Excitement in fight number 4. Two great strikers.
Absolutely.
Lots of great entertainment for the crowd here in Graz, Austria.
Fantastic. Daniel Shoji, ladies and gentlemen. We believe is going to have the decision win on this fight, smiling now in his corner after having put up a war in the third round. Local fighter from Austria, definitely happy to see him win in front of his home crowd. Marcel Simo also has to be proud of himself for having finished this fight. He put up a great fight, made some damage, and could have been able to win this fight. So if he fought it again, I'd watch this fight again. Fighters now waiting for the judge's decision, which is going to be brought to us by our ring announcer, Buddy Johnson. Buddy Johnson now entering the cage to bring us the result of this fourth and last amateur bout of the evening before the first pro undercard bout of the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout goes the distance, and we go to your judges for the decision. The first judge scoring the bout 29-28 in favor of the blue corner. Judge 230-27 in favor of the red corner. And now third and final judge, 29-28, declaring your winner by split decision, Daniel Shoji.
Daniel Shurjah, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the final amateur bout of our evening, delighting the crowd.